Honey, you're not even taking me seriously, are you? Yes, I know I'm new to this game, but that doesn't mean you need to baby me like this. The thing got me by the back. That's not my fault. That's not. Sorry, honey. I can't recall how many times we've even restarted this level. Because of me. There was progress at first, but that seemed to slip so quickly. How is this even player friendly to new players like me? Why are you smiling like that? I was just afraid you weren't going to have fun with me, I guess. I'm not exactly the best at games, unlike you, so. Yeah, I guess you are the best. Of course. It was fun for me too, honey. And I mean it. But I guess you just had to carry my ass, not going to lie. Does your back hurt from that? Or maybe your hands feel heavy? Should I hold them for you? I mean it though. Look at the time, honey. It is getting late. Going home at a time like this, wouldn't really be worth it. No, you don't have to drive me home. I can do it myself, but is it really necessary for me to leave right now? Yeah, that's what I meant. I would love to stay over for a night, if that's okay with you. Oh, do you have anywhere to be in the morning tomorrow? I see. Are you sure it will be okay? I mean, I know I suggested it, but I won't be disappointed or anything. I promise. I understand. Then, if you insist, I will gladly oblige. Oh, I can sleep on the couch, honey. Don't worry about it. But your bed is a bit small for the both of us, isn't it? Honey, No, I will not take sleeping on your bed myself as an answer. I'm the guest here, and this is your apartment, so please. What do you mean, precisely? What do you mean you come prepared? So you're saying is, you'll sleep on the floor beside me? If you're insisting that, come on, honey. I'll be the one sleeping on the floor. You're the one doing me a favor by letting me stay over. And look, I can't even see your face when I'm up here. If we're going to sleep in the same space, then I really want to lay beside you, honey. Unless there's enough space for the both of us on the floor. Well, I guess I am clingy. So what? Are you complaining? That's what I thought. Well, you do look really pretty when you're asleep, though. And I'm glad I'm the only person who gets to see you like that. Maybe when we finally move in together, a shared apartment, we can finally get a larger bed for the both of us. And that way, we can fall asleep to each other every night. honey, can you take a look at this? No, I need you to come up here for a moment. I'll be really quick, I promise. Finally got you. Oh, no, no, no. You're not allowed to go anywhere else. Now get under the covers of me. No, honey. I really have something to tell you. Really. Just believe in me. Please. Look. If I curl smaller like this, you'll have enough space on your end. Right? I am quite smaller in frame compared to you after all. This is fine with me. Really. You're just coming up with excuses. I do not kick at night. You know that. Listen, I'm fine being like this. Trust me. And I just need you beside me. Okay. Just wanna feel your warmth, your touch, your embrace alone is more than enough for me. And I hope you feel the same as well. Being so close like this, so close to you, already makes me feel so much for you. It's not like I don't before, but you ever get that feeling, like, as much as you love someone, then love being around them makes you feel comfy, and somehow my heart isn't used to this yet. You feel like home, and yet being so close after all these years, my heart still beats so hard at the sight of you. Just like day one, beating out of my chest like it's our first date, every single time. I never get bored when I'm with you. Never. Because you're special to me. And you will always be. You know, honey, previously I would think that never in my life I'd get to be intimate and love someone so much. I thought I was used to being single, being independent, and not needing someone to walk with in life. Keeping secrets to myself. Living by myself. I was afraid I wouldn't be able to open up to someone the way people do in a relationship. But ever since you walked into my life, I gave into it. I gave into everything. Your touch, your warmth, your love, and most importantly, you. And now I feel like I can't live without you in my life. Was used to being by myself, watching my friends happy with their partners, thinking I was fine with making things alone. That would suffice. I never thought I would need a presence beside me so much until I met you. I love you. And I love you so much, honey. And I'm so lucky and happy to have met you. You're so patient with me and have been nothing but wonderful towards me. And it would certainly mean the world if I made you feel the same way. I hope I'm able to make you feel the same way as happy you've made me, honey. Now, let me love you. I want to take care of you too, okay? Just like how you do for me. That should be alright, right? I promise. I'll do anything for you. So don't be surprised if you wake up tomorrow to the smell of coffee and see breakfast made. May I perhaps know how does the love of my life like their eggs in the morning? Yes, know that. You shall have the best eggs you will ever have in your life. First thing in the morning. I will try my best. Well, even if they're not the best tasting ones, they're definitely going to be full of my love. Oh god, I'm starting to regret everything. I can't even really run away or turn away from you because of how close we are in your bed together. Yes. Well, isn't this the consequences of my own actions? You silly little. Since I can't run, you might as well hold me closer. Don't you think? That way, you definitely can make sure I won't run away from your embrace. Well, it's not like I would want to anyways, but you know. saying goodnight, baby. I'll see you in the morning.